best format that's ever been created based on Tinder. That we know of.
That's probably true.
Right, maybe. That we know of. And Tinder, if you don't know what Tinder is, good for you. You're living your life right. And I hope that your significant other also doesn't know what it is. If you don't know what Tinder is, it's an app for dating, and it's horrible. And you just get, like, a picture of someone, and it's very little information about them. And if you don't like them, you say swipe left, and they go away forever. And if you like them, if they're interesting, if you want to see more of them, you say swipe right, and then you get to hang out with them potentially. So here we're going to have some big characters presented to you.
I've never used it.
And so you'll see some big characters, you'll get to know them a little bit, and if one of us wants to see more of them, we'll say swipe right, and we'll play around with that until that runs out. And thank you for being along on the ride. For our players, for the four of us, we each want to get some inspirations of kinds of characters that you might see. So what I need from you is name an object that you might be able to purchase, because that could be anything.
Army.
Here's a light bulb is the first thing that I saw. So for Chris, when you think of light bulb, what does that make you think of?
Inventions.
Okay, so his characters, at least some of his characters, will be inspired by the idea of inventions. John, when I say light bulb, you think of what?
A fixer.
Okay, awesome. Kevin, light bulb.
Shattered glass. First thing.
I think of like an interrogation. Mine will be inspired somehow by interrogation.
Good.
Great. So here we go. Here is swipe right.
I am Dr. Cohen. I was awarded the Nobel Prize for inventing the artificial appendix.
Swipe left!
It was a little thing, you know. It started with just a glass, and I liked the sound that it made, you know, in every room. And I thought, maybe if something is bigger, it made of glass, it would make a bigger noise.
Swipe left!
Hi, I'm Joshua. I'll be your mediator today. I want you to know that we've created a safe space and that all feelings are valid. And before we can have peace, I want you to really think about the love you have for yourself.
Swipe right! Joshua, you should have seen the way that she looked at me, though!
I did see the way she looked at you, Jake.
I wanted to strangle her! Is that valid?
Well, that's a strong emotion.
Yeah!
Jake, I want you to know that that's valid, but strangling is not. I'm sorry, Jake.
It's valid! You said valid! No take back!
I did. Jake, I feel like you're not. Do you want to cry right now, Jake?
No!
Jake, I think that you want to cry.
Get it out of me!
Jake, I don't know why, but when I look at you, I think of a sparrow.
So, why do you have the connection to that patient?
Well, I guess, can I tell you something horrible? That morning I hit a bird. tell me about the bird. And I had it on my mind a lot.
Would you, it's our sixth session. Would you like a chair?
I feel very, I want to respect your wisdom. I brought one knee up.
I appreciate that. We've made progress.
Now we regress.
Don't touch the shoes, all right? I'm not Jesus, and you're not a disciple.
No, that is what Jesus would say.
Yes. Jesus would be Jesus frequently.
Well, I mean, he would say that that's his name, but I feel like he wouldn't be like, I'm Jesus.
Let's get back to the bird.
Okay.
What'd you do?
Well, it made a mess on the Prius.
And why didn't you offer him a seat of some sort?
Because I'm sick of these whiners, okay? I gotta be Mr. Oh, tell me about the bird. I don't care about the bird, okay?
You chose to be a therapist.
I chose to be a therapist. I did, because I like to restrain myself and bring it in and just be like,
Consider restraining when you're here as well.
This was a safe space.
I thought so too until you got here. Carol, can you?
Don't call Carol. I cut the cord. You gonna look for outside help?
That's valid.
It's gonna happen. That's valid.
Your anger makes me feel unsafe inside. Mm. I feel like I should let you know that.
Good.
Oh.
Oh, we reversed roles. Sorry. Look, I'm mad, okay?
I just felt really scared. Yeah, I was starting to open up to you. I just feel you made me feel scared.
I understand that.
Did you get a new follower?
It's good.
I thought you loved me.
I'm sorry.
What's that?
Oh, you. I had
you. Sure.
I had a double book. Please get up. We've regressed. We've regressed. Hey,
swim up!
Okay, here's the thing. The government wants to fuck you. I could say that it's nefarious, but it wants to fuck you, and until you accept that it wants to fuck you, you don't understand the way it works.
Swipe left!
Sliced bread? What kind of whammy is that invention? We need results here, not just crazy cockamamie ideas. That's a bad egg, I tell you.
Swipe left!
In the time of my father, and before him, and before my father's father, lived in the darkened wastes beyond that land, Valcor, an entity with eyes surrounding its skull. And I swore upon my birth as a baby in the crib that Valcor and I would once meet in battle.
My brain! Mr. Corwin?
Yes?
Can we get back to the English lesson?
I don't think this wasn't part of the book. Okay.
Which class is this? What did you sign up for?
Well, I'm beginning to question that myself.
Answer.
I thought English Lit.
Aha, English Lit. And you?
Yes.
English Lit.
English 201.
Ah, Valcor versus me. What is that, man versus nature or man versus man? Perhaps man versus himself?
is that going to be on the test? I wish it wouldn't. Okay.
Yes.
If you were Valcor, then that would be man versus man?
Perhaps it would be. And there I found myself, standing before Valcor, in the darkened wastes, where I had trudged to, through many battles. And as I stood there, I said, I, a community college professor, will take you down with me. Valcor and I battled for many days. I knew not whether day had come, nor night had fallen, for all the spheres in the heavens gathered in one place to watch.
Is this going to be on the PowerPoint slides at all?
Prepare yourself.
You made a slide for it? Okay.
The slide is coming. Prepare yourself. When the battle was done, this is what emerged. Behold, Valcor.
That's the provost.
Yes.
She dressed in leathers just for the photo, or is that like a person?
I dressed him that way as a mark of shame. And I said, will you be unleashed upon the darkened wastes again, or will you give me tenure?
Promised me you wouldn't put those photos online, and now I'm the laughingstock of the community college.
To be fair, I put them on a PowerPoint. The students shared them to Facebook.
Sorry, I got a pizza here for Falcor.
You son of a bitch.
Bring it here.
Okay. Just ordering pizza under your real name.
No, that's what's paid for in advance. It was just a joke. You Falcor.
See, this is why I can't give you tenure. This is what I have to deal with now.
You deal with that as I do. We battled for many days. Remember you not? Remember you not the heavenly spheres gathering to watch?
Corin, I'm the provost, and that was the Renaissance Festival.
Heavenly spheres take on many forms. Now tell me.
How they spit in it.
Is a gag pizza delivered by students who have spat upon it man versus man? Perhaps man versus society, or man versus himself.
You're fired.
Sweat us!
Cheers, Arthur.
Simmons. I live at 401 Elm Street.
Swipe left.
I'm gonna make you talk. You sit down. Nice candlelit environment. I have ways to make you have a conversation with me.
Swipe right.
Give her some water.
I've never understood why they call it Chili's 2. Like, why not just Chili's?
Milgram, Denise, born September 10th, 1987.
That's right.
I know things about you.
It's wonderful. Well, I'd like to know something about you. What's your last name, James?
We'll get to that later. I'll ask the questions.
Okay.
How was your day?
It was fine. It was fine. I'm a cosmetologist, and I work at the nail salon.
What's the worst thing you've ever done to somebody?
I once broke a man's heart just to see his face when I did it.
It still burns.
Not
now, Jeremy!
I'm so sad without you.
This is Jeremy. This is James, Jeremy.
Hi. He's gonna hurt me.
Fast forward 5 years. How does it feel? Just look at me when you...
That wasn't a joke?
No. Oh, this is my favorite part.
Last time you said you loved me more than anyone you've ever known.
I invited Jeremy.
Seem interested in me very. I don't even know why I'm. Guys, do you like playing Dungeons and Dragons? I think that's when I was my happiest.
That's quite right.
Well, hey, neighbor.
Hey there.
How's it going?
It's going well. How'd you like to be my mage?
Come in.
Just a couple of us next door were in the middle of a campaign, and we thought that we needed a mage, and your topiary works amazing, and I just thought if you could do magic with the...
Come inside where they're playing a game.
So, I brought my lopping shears. Is that what mages do?
Right, laughing.
It's funny.
You'll have to excuse Patrick. He's an elf. So, and Jerry here is kind of interesting. He's a multi-class character, and he's a paladin healer type. He wouldn't go more clear than that. Anyway,
and I have nunchucks.
Jerry, this is what you do instead of coming to the neighborhood swapping shop.
I have a regular thing.
Jerry has amassed quite the collection of gold.
He's up 50,000 just in the last hour.
It's a plastic token.
It's not actual gold.
It's representative.
Do you understand fiction? Do you understand fiction?
But you kids need to learn some responsibility, right?
I'm 29 years old.
Okay.
Oh my God.
All right. So you are angering the dragon right now when you say that to him.
Dragon.
This is, guys, I told you, it's going to be in character. So
game time continues.
Yeah. So you told the dragon that it needs to grow up, and it is not good.
What? You rolled a 6.
Yeah.
Seven.
Okay. That's not good.
You need permission for certain spells. Permission to cast level 12.
Permission is granted. Thank you for asking.
Okay. I take his brand new 2015 facade and scrawl my name in fire across the hood.
Oh, that's a... I'm sorry, that's a critical hit. You're good.
I need to ask
you.
To
do it. I'm sorry. We like to keep it authentic, spare. So
just have a seat. Have a seat.
Right, remember?
Is he going to fuck with my car? Is that what's going to happen?
He succeeded on the roll, so I'm pretty...
The die has spoken.
You touch that car, I'm going to rip your head off.
Okay, now you've got to roll for that.
Seamus Jobs, my brother Steve gets all the credit, but I've invented stuff. Like, here, it's a tin can tied to another tin can, and...
Soy break. I hope you boys brought your appetite. This is a big turkey this year.
Gee, thanks, Mom.
Seamus, grab a chair, hon.
Sure.
Hi, Mom.
So, I was...
Steven! Have a seat, boys.
Hi.
Well, you haven't seen each other in like 5 years,
yeah?
Seamus is now the manager at the Blockbuster Video that's closing down.
Yeah. We thought it was going to be the innovation in home entertainment, and it didn't really work out.
No. But he tried. He tried.
I tried.
You're a trier.
Yes.
Your brother's a doer, but you're a trier.
Winthrop, my coat.
Yes, sir. Stephen, you don't need your manservant to come to Thanksgiving dinner.
He has a name.
I'm Winthrop. Thank you very much.
Is there anything else, sir?
Go ahead and bring out the geese from the bed.
Would you like the formal geese or your casual geese?
A casual goose.
A casual goose it is, sir.
Did you bring a goose to Thanksgiving dinner?
I did, Mom. Just for you.
Seamus, Stephen brought a goose to Thanksgiving dinner.
Well, I have a servant, too, you know.
You do?
Yeah.
Who is he?
That's me. This is,
Oh, hi, Tom.
Hey.
Here we are.
Hey, Tom. Hey, Tom and I brought him here.
Tom is Seamus' boyfriend and his employee at the Blockbuster that's closing down.
Good to meet you, Tom.
Good to meet you.
This is Steve Jobs. He's the CEO of Apple Computers.
Do you have any geese in the car? Did you bring any geese?
What the fuck would I bring geese?
Watch the language.
I'm sorry. Do you want? I saw some geese.
Can you go get a goose?
There were some that were wearing formal attire. Don't look at me. It was as weird to me as it sounds.
Okay. I just need a goose. Just go get a goose, please. Right now.
I love you so much.
I love you too.
Out of love, not anything.
I know.
You were right about Blockbuster. I love you. God damn it. I love you.
It's okay.
I love you so much. I don't think the family thing.
You're welcome.
No! Oh, God.
You did what?
See? I have a servant, too.
More of a partner relationship is a better way to look at that.
Sergio, casual gifts.
Thank you, my friend. You're looking nice.
I also have feelings towards you, sir.
that's neither here nor there.
I just noticed that the other servant was allowed to claim his feelings, so I thought perhaps this was a special family.
Go ahead, Winthrop. It's Thanksgiving. Proceed.
I appreciate you, and I know I can rely on you anytime I need anything.
You know when you bite into a pizza and it's good and your mouth's sort of watering with yearning for it? I emotionally feel that way towards you, sir.
He wants to bite you.
Oh, but no. I mean, yes. But, yes.
Well, does anyone want to see the slightly smaller set of tin cans that I invented this year?
We'll be upstairs.
She wore her slinky dress.
Not the slinky dress. I saw it.
The Amy's gonna hate song.
Oh, that's
which we both know the title of. So we'll move on. and I wore my handmade shirt.
Oh, you weren't there with your handmade shirt
with the blinky with the light bright.
No, I like to have fans backstage sometimes.
Suicide to get back.
How could you not have been? How could you not have so much in that club? You're like anchor, which is just like,
yeah.
Oh my god.
You know, I like to visit hospitals with people who almost died because they love me so much.
New guy.
that? What is there to?
You're getting old and blind. You can't see me. Anymore.
I can see you just fine.
Oh?
Yeah.
How many fingers am I holding up?
Fuck you.
That wasn't a number. You're losing your marbles, old man.
Lose my marbles? Hey, Dan Simmons.
Are all homeowners association meetings like this?